Hello there everyone, welcome to another counter set video, and this time I will cover some stages in the challenge, and hopefully this video can help you go through it and get the 3 medals. And the stages are that I'm talking about are more specifically stage 311 until 315. I'm sure that if you are watching this video, most likely you already know what we are up against. And yeah, I also have difficulties here. That's why I made this video, in order to help you know what I have learned and what I do, what I have done in order to pass these stages here. And hopefully this video can help you do that. So I will do a simple introduction first about the units that I bring to these stages and why I bring them. And let's start with Gabriel first. And I think Gabriel is pretty self-explanatory. Basically, we need a tower unit in order to stop the siege rhino, the siege type rhino MK2 from advancing. Because it's a siege unit, it will ignore every other counters, mech or soldier units beside tower units. That's why we need to bring one of the tower units, and I believe Gabriel is perfect for this job. He will not bring her on many stages, but this stage is one of the stage where you will really need her. That's why I bring her. Tarascu, it's a mech unit with defense threat passive ability. That's why I bring it, basically just for the defense minus 20% here. Chifuyu is also Chifuyu and Roy Bunet is also there. Yeah, but I will explain more later. They are also there for the defense threat ability. Hayami Sanae, she is also one of the niche unit you really don't bring to many stages, but this stage is one of the stage where you really want to bring her, and that's just because of her passive ability, basically buffing ally to do more damage against siege units. So she is very very good here, and that's why I bring her. The next one is Chifuyu. I just like Chifuyu in general. She's an all-around great character, good attack, good HP, and very nice passive too, and defense minus 20%. That's why I bring her, and also very very cheap on just 3. She's the leader, that's why it's 2. Next is Sylvia Lena Cooper. Basically, she is just here for the her stun ability. So when you deploy her, she will use her special skill which stun units, and that's why I bring her, and I will deploy her just at the right time in order to stun the Rhino MK2, because the Rhino MK2, it's a siege attacker. By the time it reaches Gabriel, it will stop for a while, then try to use its skill that will one-shot kill Gabriel, and we would like to stop it from using the skill by stunning it at the right time. So that's why we bring Sylvia here. And for the next one, Roy Bunet, same story as Chifuyu and the tank before. For his defense threat ability and also damage taken amplification. The defense threat comes from his ultimate skill, and this is the damage taken amplification from his passive. That's why I bring him. Administration Rifleman is just there for as damage dealer and also for dealing with air units. And Soyun is just a very very good all around buffer units, increasing ally attacks, and also additional enemy defense on her special skill here, and just damage dealer too. So just an all-around very very good unit, and I believe you bring Soyun in many many stage. For the ship, why Stellar? Stellar come equipped with a stun ability that's also very useful, so we can stun the Rhino twice. It will give us more time to kill it before it kills Gabriel. That's why I bring Rhino here. And I don't know about the operator if it really matters, but I bring Lena Mackenzie here just because I like the order of her skill activation. And her skill is, I believe, it's quite good actually. Grant attack speed to all allies for 12 seconds, and I can activate it very easily. Just put down Tarescu, Hayami, and then Tanahari Chifuyu, and I will activate it. That's why I bring her. So I will use these units, this ship, and this operator on all these 5 stages. And I hope that you guys also have these units, because as you can see, I really really tried to come up with the units that I think most of the players have. And as you can see, all of these units are pretty basic units. There is no awaken units or some units that are harder to get or are newer, so maybe less player have them, but these units are pretty basic, and I believe most player have them. And also, if you notice about my equipment here, there is really nothing special. As you can see, yes, there are some maze here and there, but I really really try to be more general so that most people can do it. As you can see, it's just HP on Gabriel. On the Tarescu, it's just very very basic attack speed set that you get from the beginner plan, from the beginner mission. For Hayami, it's just also the very basic attack speed stat. For Nanahara Chifuyu, it's my base attack speed main set right now. I don't know, maybe it will suffice to bring something less better, something worse, but yeah, that's what I bring. Sylvia Lena Cooper, with my best cooldown reduction mace set right now. Roy Burnett with just some random cooldown reduction set, and also the Administration Rifleman with some random attack speed set for the soldier. So Yun with some random cooldown reduction too. So yeah, as you can see, I believe that if you really want to, you can replace any of the equipments or any of the units here with some better ones. For example, as damage dealer, maybe Awakened Soyun is better than the Administration Rifleman here, for example, or maybe Chifuyu. Yeah, so basically feel free to experiment or to replace the units here if you have some better ones or better equipments. I don't mind. I don't have the right to mind, of course, but yeah, you get the gist of it. So, without further ado, let's get to it. From Act 311, let's start. So basically what you will do is the same for every stage. Just put the Gabriel here. Then we wait. We wait until the Rhino goes forward, so that you can put your units behind it so that they don't get any damage from the Rhino. So, put the tank first. Hayami, Chifuyu, skill from operator activated. And we wait until it reach the wheel. Then put the Lena cover in order to stun it. Pop. And then it is stunned. Its ability is cancelled. You wait until it uses 2 normal attack. That's 1. That's 2. Then you stun it with the ship ability. And just like that, don't forget to keep deploying your units. And then we wait for the win. It's actually pretty simple. It just needs some practice, and then you will understand what you have to do. And I will help you go through all these 5 stages and show you what you will do. And I really hope that you can manage. And that's Act 311 down. Let's get to the next one. 312. As you can see, same exact unit, same ship, same operator. Let's go. The only difference is that I'm too fast, but I will explain later. So Gabriel here. Now we wait. As you can see, now it also spawned this mini tank here, and that is a defender in order to annoy us. But it's fine. There is no change in what we do. So once again. Put the tank down. Ayami. For you. Wait. Put Lena to go down. Then I will stun it. Very nice. Don't forget to put the other units down. Wait until it attack twice. One. Then we start it. It's pretty simple, right? So now just keep deploying your units. And there you have it. It's actually pretty easy once you get the Gizzy. We still have another 3 stage. And of course they came with extra difficulty, but we'll do just fine. Let's two down, on to the next operation. 313 now, and as you can see there is a chopper. There is now an extra basalt unit. It's a sniper and it's also an air unit, so that's why we will need a rifle unit. And I bring Sincha here, but actually I will just to show you administration rifleman will do just fine too. And let's do it. 전승문 전투 태세로. Clear down. Now we wait. Just like last time. 가용 에너지는 충분해요. So the tank is down. I am for you. Then getting ready to deploy Lena. Put Lena down. Start. Now we will have to attack twice once more. That's one. That's two. Start it now. And we wait. Then we win. That's it. As you can see, it's pretty easy once you get the Gizzard. And for side note, be careful when you put Lena here, because sometimes if you Lena will target the farthest enemy from her, and if you put her too close to the Rhino, it might target the chopper behind, because the chopper is on the other side. So be careful. So that's why I on this stage I put Lena more to the right side in order so that the Rhino is the farthest unit from it, and so that it is stunned, not the chopper. I will just show you again on the next one. So now 314, and what's the gimmick this time? Now it came with an extra soldier, Iron Sight. Iron Sight will spawn near your ship, but it's fine, there is Gabriel there. 전승문, 전투 태세로. Gabriel down. Now we wait. I put Gabriel here just so that it is not too close to our ship, but also not too far. Put the tank, Hayami, Chifuyu. Just like last time. And then we put Lena a bit to the right. Very nice. Wait until it attack twice. One. Two. And we start. Nice timing. As you can see, sometimes there are units from this side, and also there was a chopper here. That's why you have to be careful when putting down Lena. You have to put her a bit to the right, just so that this Rhino is the farthest unit from her, and then she throw the stun in this way and not this way. So be careful about it. Just wait for the win. very simple, and I believe by this time you will probably get the hang of it, and you are ready for the last penultimate battle, which is the stage 3 15 next operation 315. Prepare to operate. Yep, same units, same ship, same operator. Let's go. Put Gabriel down. Then we wait until Rhino pass as usual. It will happen when your deployment is almost full. So right now, Hayami, Chifuyu, and then we prepare to deploy Lena Cooper. So here, I would like to deploy Lena Cooper now, but as you can see, there is a Cooper here. So you have to be really careful on how you deploy Lena. I believe here will be a good spot. I hope it is. Let's try. Right, and Lena will throw her skill on the farthest unit in her range. Yep. And it goes to this side. It is done. Nice. Keep deploying more units. And this fight is much more difficult than the last one. As you can see, my sniper dies here from the chopper alone, just because of the level. I think the level is higher, that's why it now hits harder. And as you can see, Gabriel will soon die, so I will just save my deployment cost until Gabriel dies and just redeploy her again. So yeah, this battle is unfortunately a little bit difficult than the last ones. So I will just deploy her now, I think. Yep. And then we will soon have to stun the ship again. So pay attention. This is the second attack, I believe. The second normal attack after the last skill it tried to use. Stun her. I stun it now. So, and then, yeah, we just keep deploying the dead units. Hayami will be deployed again. It is stunned again from the skill from Lena, fortunately. Soyun. And I believe here it will use its skill again, and this time I don't have anything more to stun it, so you will see how Gabriel die in one hit from this skill. But I believe we will have enough time just before our ship is destroyed to defeat the boss. So as you can see, this like here marks that it will use its ultimate skill now. As you can see, Gabriel just dies in one shot from it. Yeah, but yeah, fortunately for us, it will soon die, and yeah, we won't have to worry about it. So yeah, just like that. Yeah, as you can see, all the stages before are basically just practice stages for this one, because this one the enemies hit harder. You will have to deploy some units once more because they will die, and yeah, and you will just have to be more careful with your time. But yeah, we defeated, we get 3 medals. We defeated before 130 minutes, 1.5 minutes basically. Yeah, and I hope you guys have fun watching it, and yeah, good luck on your try, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.